Are you getting? The application has unexpectedly stopped working. 0x80070057 error for Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3. Then you are at the right place. We have got some easy ways that you can use to fix the issue. Welcome back to Silicophilic, your go-to source for tech tips and fixes. Before we move forward, make sure to subscribe to our channel and like this video. It's free and helps us a lot. We do tons of research to find the working solutions for you. Your little support will help us continue making solution videos for you and others. So let's dive right in. Method 1. Verify the game files. To verify the game file, go to the Steam library and right-click on the game. Then open its properties. Go to the Install Files tab and select the Verify Integrity of Game Files option. After the verification, launch the game and check. Method 2. Link your Steam and Activision accounts. Visit the Activision website at https://www.activation.com. Click on Visit Site. If you have an account, then sign in with your credentials. If you do not have an account, click on the Sign Up button and fill up the details. Click on the Sign Up button. Then enter the required credentials and again click on Next. Select your birthday, location, and click on Next. Set a password. Check the boxes and click on Next. You can give your contact number, although it's optional. Then check the boxes and click on Next, or you can skip it. Finish the steps as shown to create an account. Once you are logged in, go to your profile. Then select the account linking option. Click on Link Account next to the Steam account. Enter your Steam account credentials and follow the on-screen instructions to finish the process. If you have already linked the accounts and getting the error, then unlink and link the accounts. Visit the same page to link accounts. Click on Unlink option beside Steam account. Next, click on Send a Code option. Go to your email, copy the code sent and enter it to the respective field. Next, click on Submit. Again, you will have to click on the Unlink option beside the Steam account. This time, you should see a warning message. Read the terms and conditions carefully and check the box for I understand and wish to continue option. Then click on the Continue button. Once the unlinking is successful, link the accounts again. Now you will be redirected to the Steam site to verify your login credentials. Click on the Continue button. Once done, launch the game and see if the problem is fixed. Method 3. Uncheck compatibility from Steam and the game exe file. Before you perform this method, exit Steam. Then type Steam in the Windows search menu and right-click on the top option. Select Open File Location. Locate the Steam exe file and right-click on it. Select Properties and go to the Compatibility tab. Uncheck the box for Run this program in compatibility mode for if it is checked. Click on Apply, then click on OK. Repeat the same thing with the game exe file. For this, open Steam. Right-click on the game from the Steam library and select Manage. Then click on Browse Local Files. It will take you to the game installation folder. Find the game exe file and right-click on it. Open its properties. Then go to the Compatibility tab and uncheck the Run this program in compatibility mode for option. Then scroll up and repeat the same for the exe file inside the SP23 folder. Method 4. Let the shaders optimization be 100% complete. While launching the game, if you see shaders optimization at the top left side, then let it be 100%. Then launch the game. Method 5. Allow the game .exe file through Windows Security and Firewall. Windows Security and Firewall can be extra protective sometimes and interfere with your game. So, allow the game through Windows Security or any antivirus program you are using and then launch the game. Type Windows Security in the Start menu and press Enter. Select Virus and Threat Protection. Click on Manage Settings. Scroll down to the Exclusion section. Click on Add or Remove Exclusions. Click on Yes in the UAC prompt. Click on the Add an Exclusion button and select File. Navigate to the Game Installation folder and select the game .exe. Click on Open. Make sure to add the .exe file from the SP23 folder also. Add -dx11/-d3d11/-dx12 in the launch options. Go to the Steam library, right-click on the game and open its properties. Go to the General tab. In the launch option, type dx11 and then launch the game. If this doesn't work, enter -d3d11 or -dx12 in the launch options and check. Method 6. Run the game as an administrator. The game may need administrative privileges to run. So right-click on the game from the Steam library and select Manage. Then click on Browse Local Files. It will take you to the game installation folder. Find the game .exe file and right-click on it. Then open its properties. Go to the Compatibility tab. Check the box for the Run this program as an administrator option. Click on Apply, then OK. If that doesn't work, then open the SP23 folder. Then find the game .exe file and right-click on it. Then open its properties. Go to the Compatibility tab. Check the box for the Run this program as an administrator option. Click on Apply, then OK. Method 7. Change the region. To try a different region in Steam, open Steam Settings. Go to the Download section, try a different region and check. Method 8. Troubleshoot the graphics drivers. You should always update your graphics drivers to get a better gaming experience. So, update the graphics drivers. Right-click on the Windows button and choose Device Manager. Go to the Display Adapters section and then expand it. Right-click on your graphics driver and click on the Update Driver option. Select the Search Automatically for Drivers option and follow the instructions provided on screen to download and install the latest driver. If you have an NVIDIA graphics card, use the GeForce Experience to update the graphics drivers. Install it from NVIDIA's official website if you don't have it. Next, run the app and go to the drivers section. Look for any available updates there. If you find it, install it. For AMD graphics card users, follow the same process to update the drivers. But you will have to use the Radeon software instead of GeForce Experience. Once you have updated the graphics drivers, relaunch the game. If the issue is not fixed, reinstall the graphics drivers. Expand the Display Adapters section inside the Device Manager. Right-click on the graphics driver and click on Uninstall Device option. After uninstalling the graphics drivers, install them. Get and run the Radeon app on your PC for the AMD graphics driver. Similarly, for NVIDIA graphics drivers, install the GeForce Experience and run it. It will automatically detect the missing graphics drivers and download and install them. Once done, restart your PC. Then run the app and check for the latest updates. If any update is available, get it downloaded and installed. Method 9. Run the game in high performance. Type graphics settings in Windows Search and select the top option. Click on Browse, Go to the game installation folder and select the game .exe file. Click on Add. Once the game is added, click on the game and then click on Options. Select High Performance and save it. Repeat the same for the game .exe file inside the SP23 folder. Now launch the game and check. Method 10. Install Visual C++ Redistributables. Most of modern games require C++ Redistributable to run on the Windows PC. So install C++ Redistributables. Search Visual C++ Redistributable in Google. Click on the link of Microsoft.com. Download Visual C++ Redistributable for the latest year. Ensure you are downloading for the correct architecture like x86 for 32-bit systems and x64 for 64-bit systems. Then install the downloaded file. Once downloaded, restart your system. Launch the game and check if the issue is solved. Method 11. Try windowed mode. If you are able to launch the game, try launching it in windowed mode. Go to the game settings, select the graphics tab, and change the display mode to windowed mode. You can select a lower resolution for the game. Then scroll down and turn off the VSync. Turn off NVIDIA Reflex Low Latency. Apply the settings and check the performance now. Method 12. Reinstall the game. If nothing is working, uninstall and reinstall the game. Right-click on the game from Steam Library and select the Manage option. Select Uninstall. Once done, go to the Game Installation folder and delete it. Once you delete it, reinstall the game to a different drive and check if the issue is fixed. And there you have it. The 12 methods to fix. The application has unexpectedly stopped working. 0x80070057 error for Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3. We hope one of these methods have worked for you. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more tech tips and troubleshooting guides. Leave a comment and help others know which solution solved your problem. Thanks for watching, and we will see you in the next video.